finance. It's kind of tough to, you know, ask questions. It's, you know, such a heart-wrenching story. Could you tell us a little bit why, I mean, you decided to tackle this? This is based on a true story, something you want to, you know, put together, certain things that you see are happening. Yeah, let's start from there. So the motive of making this film, it does come from a true incident that happened, but apart from that, it's all fiction. So and he didn't have any intention to share lights to the actual incident that happened. He had always been very kind of interested in all the, you know, high teen suicide and like bullying and all the sexual crime that's happening in our society, and that was, you know, I kind of wanted to tell a story about those things.
Because one thing that is obviously striking is the fact that she's so isolated. She's so left, you know, by herself. I mean, she's been gang raped and she's going through all this absolutely devastating situation, and she's just somehow, you know, thrown away and, you know, doesn't have pretty much anybody around. So is this something that, you know, happens in general? I mean, it could just, I can't start by questioning this. It's just so outrageous. And of course you showed it so, you know, heartbreak, you know, painfully on screen. So could you elaborate a little bit about, you know, if it's, you know, something that happens like that often? I mean, I'm not saying that the raping is often, but just that putting someone aside, kind of the untouchable, and just, you know, if it's, you know, cultural, or if it's just the situation, or if, you know.
He thinks that, well, he thinks that it's kind of a dangerous to try to you know, judge the whole society just by one movie.
하지만 그 분명 이런 그 어떤 인간의 이기심, 어떤 그런 마음들이 분명히 있고, 저에게도 그런 마음이 분명히 있다는 생각이 들어서 이 영화를 만들게 되었고, 이 영화를 보신 어떤 뭐 관객분들도 어떤 그 공주가 만난 사람들 중에 한 명이 된 경우에 개인의 어떤 이기심 또는 개인주의적인 성향 때문에 외면할 수 있다, 그런 데 대한 이야기인 것 같습니다.
So, but at the same time, I do think the human being has a very, you know, cruel and kind of side that are when it when you get to be one of the many people Gongju end up meeting throughout her journey, that you might end up, that's kind of, it's kind of mirror your, like, it might be that kind of action, even though you don't think you're necessarily gonna be following their path, it's very likely that's what many people would end up doing.
I don't.
So, like being, kind of being.
Ostracized or.
Selfish, so to speak. So, even though they think it's a very not necessarily stepping up when they are supposed to, because they don't want to, you know, be involved. So they are kind of basically selfish. So they're worrying, but not necessarily doing anything. Or
yeah, because the other thing is like when they barge into the school, you know, we will think that, you know, the teachers at least will protect her. I mean, it's just like nobody really defends her at all. And you see all these people just bashing on her, and you are like, you know, she's not in like the middle of nowhere, she's in a school. So not even in that environment, she was, you know, safe, let's put it that way.
So, like the present day, the Korean school does not necessarily reflect what you're seeing in the film, but I do think there's some kind of cultural difference, you know, in it.
Before I open to the audience, of course, the actress who plays Gongshu is incredible. Could you tell us a little bit about the process of working with her on this very, you know, painful character?
It was definitely not an easy character to act, but at the same time, not being a very active character, could also see it as not, could have been easy in that sense. But it was very important that she thoroughly understood the character. So, 2 months before starting the actual production, they had a lot of conversation talking about the character and the script, having meetings 3-4 days every week.
I'm sure we have a lot of questions from the audience, and so we're gonna start. Yes.
Okay. Would you mind just sit here and speak? Yeah, okay. So I have a question for the director. I really like this film, and I'm a big fan of Korean film actually, because so there are a lot of films in recent years, Korean films, they really focus on the social issue, like social, like school bullying, teenager raping, suicide, and there's a great director called Lee Chang-dong, and he made a film called Pointu. So my question is, when you create this film, do you get influenced by other directors in Korea, or like their works? Do they have influence on their work? That's my question.
Is it Lee Chang-dong? Was that the director you mentioned?
Yeah.
What's his?
You all know.
많을 것 같습니다. 굉장히 많고 그 감독 영화뿐만이 아니라 그 한국의 어떤 문화에 많은 영향을 받았다고 생각이 듭니다.
So yeah, obviously he has definitely got influenced by a lot of films and like the whole society, the culture and everything. Seems to be hard to pick out one specific.
Yes, do we have another question? Yes, oh, okay, suddenly we have several. I'm gonna go with your view and then we'll take the other ones. Yeah.
I was confused about the father's petition. I did not understand, not knowing Korean culture, I didn't understand what that meant.
So basically, it's kind of a document that are asking to reduce their for those that usually have some kind of connections or have some kind of power, basically.
그런데 이제 영화에서 탄원서라는 것이 나오지만 그 탄원서가 어떤 영향을 미쳤다라는 것까지는 나오질 않습니다. 사실 그 아버지가 그 탄원서를 가지고 딸한테 사인을 받는다라는 어떤 그 행위 자체가 저에게는 좀 더 충격적이다라고 생각이 들었기 때문에 그 후의 이야기보다는 그 행위에 더 이 영화에서는 들어가 있다라고 생각이 듭니다.
So in the film, we are not necessarily showing what that petition are doing or kind of effect it's it has, and he kind of wanted to more focus on the fact that the father is bringing it to his daughter and asks her to sign that.
We have time for those two questions that we were there, and yes.
Beautiful film. I'm wondering at what point, when you've got your script, you've got your characters as a director, at what point did you decide the tone that you were going to hang on these languid scenes, mundane, and I found myself was so beautifully shot, the characters were so interesting, I didn't feel the story was moving along in the plot, but I wanted to stay there with the characters. Was that intentional?
When I decided that I wanted to tell the story, I wanted to picture the lead character as being, even though having been traumatized and you know, going through this awful things, still being a very strong character and kind of show that she's trying to move on and overcome her circumstances.
Yes, and we have have that last question. There was a hand. Yes.
Just simple question. Why was there no compassion for the victim after people knew what happened to her? No one seemed to be compassionate. I wanted to understand that.
친구들이 외면하는 부분은 아마 두려워서였을 것 같아요. 그 순간에 그 어떤 그 충격적인 모습을 봤을 때, 뭐 동영상이든 이야기든, 뭐 17세의 어린 나이에 그걸 받을 수 있는 그 순간에는 그런 용기가 없었을 것 같고요.
So for example, for our friends, I think. Just being at that certain age, and I think they're like afraid to, at that moment, to do any kind of take an action. It's more about not wanting help, but more about being scared at the moment.
It wasn't about the friends. It was like no one showed compassion for her when they found out. No one showed compassion. I'm trying to understand it.
But I don't think it's finished.
그리고 이제 엄마 같은 경우에는 그 순간의 어떤 이기심이었던 것 같고요. 그리고 이어서 정말로 질문하신 것처럼 섣불리 다가가지 못하는 어떤 그런 마음들이 아마 그 개인의 어떤 내가 거기에 다가갔을 경우에 나한테 어떤 일이 닥칠지에 대한 두려움이 있었던 것 같고요.
So yeah, and for instance, for the mother's character, I think it's more about selfish, and not necessarily, even though knowing that you need to take an action, not necessarily being able to be very active in that moment, and kind of a mob psychology. Yeah.
그리고 제일 중요한 거는 이제 사실 이건 픽션이죠. 예. 영화를 보는 나는 그 인물이 됐을 때 나는 어떻게 할 것인가에 대한 아마 물음도 분명히 있는 영화인 것 같습니다.
So at the end, I mean, it's a fiction, and I think what I was ultimately trying to say was. Being one of the audience, what would my take be? What would I do if I, you know, if that happened to me, or if there was someone dear to me, then, you know, what would I be doing then?
We have to wrap up. I know we have millions of questions. Thank you, Lee Jun-jin, definitely you left us thinking about a lot of things, but thank you for, you know,